Good afternoon, everybody. Now today I am going to discuss the relational database model. Relational database model is basically where the data is viewed in two-dimensional table known as relation. Each of the tables consists of multiple numbers of attributes or columns and multiple numbers of rows that is named as tuples. And out of these multiple numbers of tuples, any one of the to identify any one of the tuples, we have to keep any one of the values of the columns which should must be unique, and unique in the sense that it may have to be non-null value also. So that table we will consider as the primary key of the relational database model. Now here I am going to give an example of a relational database models where the multiple numbers of table you can see. These are the multiple numbers of tables. Two tables are there. One is the customer table where the number of attributes are customer ID, loan number, and the amount in dollars. And these are also called attributes also. And the multiple numbers of rows are there, which are known as the tuples also. Among them, any one of the columns must be termed as the primary key, which contains the unique value. Not only that, it must contain some the non-null value also. Here the customer ID is termed as the primary key because all the values are unique over here. And you can take the loan number also, but it should be unique in the sense. But if I find out that for a particular customer you have multiple numbers of loan number, that case the customer ID cannot be unique because the customer ID will appear within this table multiple number of times. Similarly, and for the second table, here we find out that customer ID, customer last name, customer middle name, first name, account number, account type, bank branch, customer emails, these are the attribute values for this table. So in that case, it's a customer profile table basically. So in that case, the customer ID must be the primary key because it consists of the unique value. Now, identify each of the rows within the table, we need to know the keys. Keys are basically the any one or multiple numbers of attributes which will help us to identify a particular row. Out of this, this can be also be termed as a super key. And we need to identify what is the difference between super key, candidate key, primary key, and alternate key. This is very important to know the fundamentals of the database and to create the different tables within the database. Now let us see how can we identify the keys. Now before going into the definition, let us check that how to identify the key. Suppose I am considering this example. A given relationship of a trainee table is given where here I am considering it as an employee table where the different attributes are employee number, first name, last name, email, and phone number is there. Now we can consider employee number only itself as to identify a particular rows within the table. So that case I can say that employee number can be a super key. So let us identify what are the super keys are there. So employee number, EMP number may be a super key. Now I have to decide that whether first name can be considered as a super key. As the first name can appear multiple numbers of times or the last name also can appear multiple numbers of times, so that case I cannot consider first name as a super key, right? But email, if I am considering the customer's profiles and also consider that email should be unique for each of the customers, that case I can consider email also as a super key. Now, first name and last name in the table, if I consider that the combination of first name and last name will be the unique in the, within this table, that case that combination of first name and last name also I can consider it as a super key, right? Super key is basically one or multiple numbers of key which will help us to identify the table uniquely. Now, phone number can also be used to identify a table. So these are the super key. Now, out of this super key, any one of them subset should be the candidate key. So what is candidate key? The definition of candidate key is that candidate key is a super key whose subset should not be a candidate key. Candidate key is a super key whose subset is not a super key. So this one is very important. Suppose if I consider out of this number of keys, if I consider any combinations as a super key, suppose if I consider employee number comma first name, this combination also I can consider it as a super key, because this combination also helped me to identify a particular row. Now, as within this combinations, as it is a super key, but it's a subset, employee number itself is a super key already, that we have seen. So this can be a super key, but it cannot be, this can be a super key, sorry, this can be a super key, but it cannot be candidate key. Similarly, if I consider first name, last name, then phone number. Now, can I consider it as a super key? The basic thing is that if I consider these combinations to identify a particular row, that case it must be a super key. So, I can say that this one is super key. Now, is it candidate key? Now, as the first name, last name and phone number as its subset, one of the subset, that is phone number, is already identified as a super key, already identified as a super key. So, this one is super key, but it can never be a candidate key. So, basic principle is that say a super key whose subset is not a super key is a candidate key. Now, considering this one, I have to decide which must be my candidate key. Now, can I consider EMP number as a candidate key out of this? Yes, because it's a single value attribute, so it doesn't have any subset. So this can be a candidate key, right? Next, phone number, employee number, phone number. No. It cannot be candidate key, because its subset employee number separately is a super key, as well as phone number separately is also a super key. But if I consider phone number only, that can be considered as a candidate key, as well as it is a super key also. Now, if I consider suppose email ID, then phone number. Is it a super key? Yes, it is a super key. Is it a candidate key? No, it is not a candidate key, because email ID separately is a super key and phone number is separately a super key. So this one is not candidate key. Now, but email ID, if I consider email ID only, that case, if I consider email ID, that is a candidate key. So I think from this consideration, candidate key, it is clear. Now, which one will be the primary key? Primary key can be any one of them can be considered as a primary key. Any one of them can be considered as a primary key. So these are actually the candidates. Now, I can consider email ID as a primary key, phone number as a primary key, or EMP number as a primary key. Now, primary key will be EMP ID. Primary key can be phone number. Primary key can be email ID. Now, which one database administrator should consider as a primary key? It depends upon the database administrator. There is no stringent rule, but there are some thumb rules are there. Thumb rules are that it must be a numeric value. Not sorry, not must, it should be. It should be numeric value. It should be a single attribute. So these two thumb rule I have to follow at the time of choosing the primary key. So if I choose this one, then EMP ID it must be a numeric value, right? So it can be 1001 or 1002 like this. Now what about phone number? Phone number also can be considered as a primary key because it's a good contender for being a primary key. But phone number can, if all the members or multiple numbers of members of a particular family having the accounts, that case they may have a common phone number. So that case it cannot be unique. So better not to choose phone number as a primary key. And email ID, as it is a combination of alphanumeric values, so it cannot be considered as the primary key. So out of this, I can find out that EMP ID is the best contestant to be a primary key. And if I choose EMP ID as a primary key, then rest of them, that is the phone number, email ID, these are alternate key. So from this definition, I think it is clear which one is super key, which one is primary key, and which one is alternate key. Now, let us go into the definition. A candidate key is a set of one or more attributes that can uniquely identify a given row in a table, and its subset cannot be a super key. And primary key, during the creation of a table, the database designer chooses any one of the candidate key from among the several to uniquely identify the row in the given table. And if I choose any one of the candidate key as a primary key, the rest of the keys will be considered as an alternate key. Now, in that particular example that I have shown, how many attributes are there? I have seen that, I have already seen that how many attributes are there. Attributes are EMP ID, first name, last name, email ID, phone number. So EMP ID, email and phone number, these three has been considered as my candidate key, right? So these are the key attributes, and these two separately as a considered as a non-key attribute. These are non-key attribute. Now another example also given in this relation. Let us check how to find out how to determine the candidate key. So in the next example, it is given that the one relationship is given. So one relationship means table x, y, z, l. These are different attributes, the following attributes is in the table, and from that I find out that x can uniquely identify a table to x comma l also can uniquely identify a table, z comma l can uniquely identify a table. These three can now can I consider these three combinations as the super key? Yes, they are super key. Now I have to find out which one are the my candidate key. Now the first contestant, that is x, is it a candidate key? Yes, it is a candidate key because it is a single key attribute, it is super key as well as candidate key also. Next, x comma l, is it a candidate key? No, it cannot be a candidate key because it's one of the subset x itself already as super key, so this one cannot be a candidate key. Now third one is the z comma l, is this a candidate key? Z comma l, z and l, these two key can uniquely identify, right? These two can uniquely identify, as well as is it, I have to find out is it any one of the subset itself is a super key. Z itself is not a super key, L also itself is not a super key, so I can consider Z comma L also as a candidate key. And what are my key attributes? So my candidate key are, what are my key attributes? So candidate key, I find it out. Now primary key can be any one of them, so but which one I should choose if I am a database administrator, which one I should choose? So if I consider the thumb rule, it must be a numeric value, and another is that it must be a single key attribute. So if I consider this one, then I can say that x must be chosen as the primary key, right? Now what should be my alternate key in that case? Out of this different candidate key, I find out the primary key. Now z and l, z l must be my alternate key. Now which one, what are the key attributes are basically my super keys. So one x is my key attribute, x comma l is a key attribute, and z comma l is a key attribute. What are non-key attributes? So I have the keys at x, y, z, l. So out of this, x is being considered as a key, z is being considered as a key, l is also being considered as a key. So my non-key attribute will be basically why. So these types of question may comes in the exam with the 4 to 5 marks. Now another case also has been given, you have to identify that which one is my primary key, right? Now the assumption for this case one is given that a customer ID, customer name, that is basically the customer profile is given. Now one customer can have only and they have given the assumption. Based on your assumption also, your primary key, candidate key, super key, everything will get changed. Here it is shown that one customer can have only one account. That case the account number can also be, I can consider it as a primary key as well as the candidate key. An account can belong to only one customer, that's it. And another condition is also given, while deciding the candidate key, do not get misguided by the data presented. Okay, fine. Now in this case, which one should be my candidate key? And another case is also given that one customer can have many accounts. So if one customer can have many accounts, that case this account number cannot be candidate key, as well as the super key also, because the values are repeating. an account belong to more than one customer. That is a joint joint account. That case, the customer ID will not repeat, but customer name may repeat. And in the case 4, now considering these two, we have to choose which one should be my primary key and which one should be my candidate key. Now in the first case, I can consider customer ID as well as account number, both of them can be my candidate key, right, separately. But we should not choose the account number as per our thumb rule, because a customer can have multiple numbers of account. That case, that account number can be repeated within this customer ID, right? So that case, customer ID we should choose.